Hello friends, welcome to Civil Prim. Today we are going to see some important MCQs of hydrology, which is repeatedly asked in TNPSC AE, GATE, IAS and some other competitive exams. The first question is, pan coefficient is defined as the ratio of the lake evaporation to the pan evaporation. It is always less than 1. Lake evaporation is also known as the depth of the evaporation. The line joining the equal depth of evapotranspiration is called isoplith. An isochrome is defined as a line joining the points of equal time interval of travel of surface runoff. Isohyetal is defined as line joining the points of equal rainfall depth. The ratio of the rainfall depth to the intensity is called hydrograph. Hydrograph is defined as the graph between discharge versus time. This equation is used to measure the potential evapotranspiration. The equation is Penman's equation, where PET is measured in, that is potential evapotranspiration is measured in mm per day, and Penman's equation is based on energy balance and mass transfer approach. A catchment has 4 rain cards installed. The allowable error of this catchment is 10% and the coefficient of variation is 30. Then find out the additional number of non-recording rain cards that are needed to install. We already know the formula, number of rain cards is equal to coefficient of variation divided by errors in percentage the whole squared. In question itself they have given coefficient of variation is 30 divided by error, that is 10%. We should substitute the error in percentage itself. So 30 by 10 the whole square is equal to 9. They have asked to find out the additional number of non-recording rain gauges. We already having 4 rain gauges. So 9 minus 4, 5. Among the 5 rain gauges, 4 number of rain gauges are non-recording rain gauges and the 1 rain gauge is a recording rain gauge. Coriolis coefficient is used to find the velocity distribution. Koestler's formula is used to find the piers and barrages. Gumbel's formula is used to calculate the prediction of flood. Manning's formula is for the open flow channel. 4 rain cut stations PQRS with normal precipitation are 780 mm, 850 mm and 920 mm and 980 mm. And the station S was not operative. Observed precipitation at the station P, Q and R are 860 mm, 930 mm and 1010 mm. Now we are going to find the observed precipitation at the station S. We already know two formulas to find the observed precipitation. One is arithmetic mean method and another is normal ratio method. If the change in the rainfall is greater than 10, we use the normal ratio method. If the change in percentage is less than 10%, we use the arithmetic mean method. Here, the change in the percentage, that is 980 minus 780 divided by 980 into 100, that is greater than 10%. So we use normal method. The formula is NS by 3, that is we don't, the station S is not operative. So the normal precipitation at the S divided by 3. 3 reference to 1, 2 and 3 ratios, and TP by NP, that is 860 by 780 1.1 plus PQ by NQ, that is 930 by 850, that is 1.09. next 930 by 920, that is 1.097. now the absorbed precipitation at the station S is 1073.7 mm. 6UH triangle in shape time base 36 hours peak discharge 18 meter cube per second. Find the area in kilometer square. We already know the flood discharge, the curve is discharge by time gives the area of the rainfall intensity for 1 centimeter. Here we already in question itself they had said that is in triangle shape. We already know the formula to calculate the area of the triangle, that is half into d into h. Here the base is time, that is 36 hours. We need to convert that into seconds. So 36 into 60 into 60, and h height, the peak discharge is 18 meter cube per second, and the area for 1 centimeter. So that for converting centimeter into meter, 1/100. Here the area is 116.64 kilometer squared. The relationship among specific yield, specific retention and porosity of an aquifer is, here the specific yield is defined as SY and specific retention is defined by SR. So the relationship between these three is SY plus SR equal to eta. Runoff coefficient is defined as the ratio of the runoff to the total rainfall into 100. Here rainfall is equal to losses plus runoff. Thank you for watching our video. For more video, subscribe our channel.